Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir, and today we are with a new YouTube series where we will learn the basic of Shopify Liquid programming and how to code in Liquid programming and how to do some of the basic stuff which you should know before starting with Shopify. So if you want to learn, please take a second and subscribe to this channel and watch out the all so you can be notified for all of the upcoming videos which I'll be adding in this playlist. So let's get into it. So first, let's understand the backend of the Shopify. So that's the backend where we have orders, products, customers, analytics, marketing, discounts, apps, and online store. We'll be working mostly in this section where we have our theme. And we are working on the Dawn latest version. So today is 5th May 2022, where I'm recording the video. The latest version of the Dawn theme is 5.0.0, and we'll be practicing all of the Liquid programming in this theme. So first of all, we will create our first Liquid template and apply it onto a page. So let's click on actions and click on edit code, where we will create our first Liquid template. So here we can, here are all of the files of the themes where we have sections, snippets, assets, config, locals. We will go through every single folder one by one in this YouTube video series. For now, we are creating a new template, which is a Liquid, which will be a Liquid file. In our case, we can also create a JSON file format where all of the sections are pulled through this folder. So we will have to code a Liquid section first in this folder. Then we can create a page template here to apply it onto a page, which will be a dynamic section. So for now, let's first create a Liquid template to apply it onto a page, so you can have a basic understanding of how the Liquid programming works. Before proceeding further, make sure you have basic knowledge of HTML and CSS. If you don't have, I will put down the link in the description where you can learn all the basics of HTML and CSS. I have created multiple videos and a complete playlist for you to take yourself from a beginner to a professional level in HTML and CSS. So let's first click on add a new template, and then click on Liquid, and from the drop down select on page, because we are creating a template for page, and then create a new template and name it new. Now create a template, and here's our new template file which is being automatically saved. In the Liquid programming, we do not need to do a starting tag. In like HTML, we do HTML and then the ending tag is slash HTML, but in Liquid programming we don't need to add a starting or ending tag, just like in other programming languages. For example, in PHP we have a starting tag for like this and then ending tag like this. So in Liquid program we can add HTML code, we can add CSS code, and we can also add JavaScript code and Liquid code within dot Liquid file. So first step, like first create a variable and then print the value of that variable, which we can do that really easily by starting with curly bracket, percentage, and then assign. It's like in JavaScript we use var, in Liquid programming we do that via assign, and then is equal to, and then in the variable name, which will be new variable. So that's my variable name, and it will be equal to first value of my first variable. And now let's close it with percentage and the curly braces. So that's the syntax of Liquid programming, where if you need to assign a new variable, or if you need to run if else condition, or if you need to run a for each loop, you will be doing that within percentage and the curly braces. And to print the value, you will need to have double brackets. And now I can just put in my variable to print the value, new variable. Now this new variable will get the value from here, which we assigned on the top. Now hit save, and apply this template to a test page. So let's go to Pages. And these are our pages which I have created before. So I already have test page created. Go to that one. And from test page, you can see that you have an option to select the template, where you can simply select the new template which we created. As you can see, we have two templates in our code section. One is contact, which I might have created before, as I create a lot of Shopify tutorials. So now, well, the template which we created is new. So select on that and click save. And now if I preview this page by clicking on view page, you can see that the value of our first variable has been showing up. So that was our first step, where we created our Liquid template and assign a value to a variable. We can also print a numeric value. So to add a string value, you will need to add commas. But for the numeric value, you can just skip it and add in a numeric value, just like 6 or like 100 or whatever you want to add in. And then once we hit save, you can see that our variable will print the numeric value here. Another basic stuff which I'll teach you in this video is how to add comments in Shopify. So in HTML, if you have an HTML code, you will have to add like this. So this will be your comment, and this is the starting tag, and that's the ending tag. So that's comment for multi-line comment for HTML. In PHP, if you code in PHP, if you have any knowledge of PHP, you can see that you will comment it like this. So that's the comment for PHP. In Shopify, we have comment like this. So that's how we will comment in Shopify. So as you can see, I have added comment, and all of this code, which is added below under this comment and comment tag, will be commented out and will not be functioning. So if we click save now, our code will be commented out. As you can see, our page is blank. Whatever we can add in here, I mean, testing comments, it won't show up because we added a comment thing. Cool. So that's how the comments work. And in next video, we'll be learning Shopify operators. That's how we can play with operators in Shopify Liquid. So keep watching the videos and don't forget to subscribe. Let's learn more about Shopify. Have a great day.